On this episode of the Grand Circle Tour podcast.
Saw you.
Message Jay if you need to know what to get.
Yeah, sorry, yellow shoes. This is the one time I'm saying don't buy something from Disney.
The soggy butt and the soggy shoes. That's just so uncomfortable. So, but yeah, it's just so great. And it once again, it's the music that really brings that attraction together.
There's the episode title, Soggy Butt, Soggy Shoes.
Hooray! The future is bright indeed. We're all of us dreaming of the better days ahead. And a part of your bright new future could be a move to where the magic lives in the greater Orlando area of Florida. One of the biggest decisions you'll make when considering a move is selecting a realtor who can successfully match you with the right home in the right location at the right price. Victor Naraki is the realtor who can help you make the move you've always wanted to. Whether you're a first-time homeowner or looking to move near Disney World, Victor is in your corner. If you are looking for an experienced real estate agent covering all of Central Florida, please visit DisneyAtYourDoorstep.com today and find out just why you should work with Victor. I encourage you to create a free, no-obligation account on his website. By doing so, you'll unlock the website's full potential and be able to enter specific criteria, save listings, and browse new properties sent to your email. Visit DisneyAtYourDoorstep.com today or visit his Facebook page, Victor Naraki Realtor. And don't forget to tell him the Grand Circle Tour podcast sent you.
The Disneyland Limited, now leaving for a Grand Circle Tour of the Magic Kingdom. All passengers board.
Star Tours announces the boarding of the Endor Express. All passengers, please prepare for immediate boarding.
Please stand clear of the doors. Por favor, manténganse alejado de las puertas.
To those guests who've just joined us, welcome. For those of you standing, please hold on to the handrails throughout our journey and stay clear of the door.
Please keep your hands, arms, and legs inside the train and remain seated at all times. Now, hang on to them hats and glasses, because this here's the wildest ride.
I am Sam, the American Eagle, and I am proud to introduce the Grand Circle Tour Podcast, a celebration of Disney parks, but mostly the American ones. I really like these guys.
All aboard Grand Circle Tour passengers, and welcome to another episode of the Grand Circle Tour Podcast. My name is Dan Hansen, and I will be your host and conductor today as we take you on a tour around all things Disney. Today, I have my two favorite co-hosts. Ladies first, starting with Ringmaster Holly. Holly, how are you today, and what's up?
I am doing great. It's been a crazy busy day. We started out the morning with church, and then a birthday party for the twins, and now I'm recording. So, I'm going to sleep well tonight. But this past Friday, which feels like a million days ago, but was a day and a half, we did a meetup with a bunch of Disney friends from Instagram. And had you told me that I was going to meet people from Instagram and go hang out with them 2 years ago, I would have told you, are you freaking crazy? There's no way that would ever happen. But we met some really cool moms from Instagram and we've all become friends. So we did a meetup and did the Pluto's Pumpkin Pursuit. So like the egg hunt, but this time with pumpkins. With our kids, there were 17 kids. Wow. It was more like a field trip, but it was so much fun. And it's crazy because we've met these people like during the pandemic where we weren't going to the parks and we were just messaging or liking each other's photos. And it's pretty cool now to be able to go and actually meet in person.
That's cool. So, I always tell you, Holly, that I'm jealous of your location and how close you are to Disneyland, because it must be so cool. Just be like, yeah, I'll just go to that one of those events, you know?
Yes, we're very lucky.
Very cool. Love the Instagram community.
Mm-hmm.
I'm new to it as well, but I'm starting to love it. So,
yeah.
Thank you all our Instagram followers. And also with us, my other favorite co-host, we have Skipper Jay. Jay, how are you? And what's up?
Aloha, everyone. I am fantastic. Passengers, you can't see it, but the three of us were still wearing what we wore to the Met Gala last week. and we all look fantastic still. You can't tell that we've been living in these clothes.
We went right from the George roast right to the Met Gala in the same clothes, wore them all week, and now we're probably going to change tonight.
Maybe, so maybe. I'm really liking this vintage Coco Chanel skipper suit.
It looks great.
I'm totally picturing that.
You know, my little bandana's got rhinestones. I think I look, I may never take this off.
Holly does have the hat she could give you.
Speaking of that, I have a pair of Wallys this week, and one of them is Holly. Holly.
Holly's a Wally.
Holly's my Wally. Holly, thank you so much. I got a box in the mail, big box from someone named Crawford. She got me the Jungle Cruise ice cream boat from Disneyland and a Jungle Cruise hat from the movie premiere.
Oh, so you do have the hat.
So I want everyone to know, thank you, Holly.
You're welcome. I knew I had to give you one of them.
You just like big, big smile on my face. So when you walk in my office, both are there for everyone to see.
Missouri, cool. Missouri is closer to California than New York. So mine will probably be like another day, right? In the mail?
Yeah, totally.
If not, I'll pick it up and drive it to you. my second Wally this week, because we are doing a music episode, Disney Music Emporium finally has released the Legacy Collection soundtrack to Hunchback of Notre Dame. 38 tracks, 2 discs. You can get it at the Disney Music Emporium for $19.99 with shipping, or you can get it on iTunes for $19.99. I picked it up on iTunes. If you like this movie, if you love Disney music, this is a great deep dive into an underrated nice. Disney film.
Very cool.
I've been seeing the Disney Emporium has been doing some sort of ads with a lot of Instagrammers. And so they are all over right now. Have you seen them, Dan, too?
Yeah,
like, yeah. It's everywhere. And they're so cool. And I don't know if they gave them, like, the record players too. They had to have. But it's really cool because I'm like, oh, Jay has that one. Oh, Jay has that one too. Like,
and I hate to talk smack on Yellow Shoes. They sell a Crossley turntable on the Disney Music Emporium site. Whatever you do, do not buy a Crossley. I've had nothing but nightmares with them. The belt wears out within weeks, and don't just skip over the Crossley if you see it.
Message Jay if you need to know what to get.
Yeah, sorry, David, Yellow Shoes. This is the one time I'm saying don't buy something from Disney.
Got it.
Okay, my world's up. I am on my quest, which I don't know if you guys have started your quest too, but I'm sure you guys, if you haven't started, you'll start soon, to collect all 50 Happy Meal toys. Have you guys started your quest yet?
Oh. No.
I did not.
Are you going to start that quest?
No.
All right. After a weekend of trying, here's my advice. Don't do it.
Yeah.
Terrible.
So are they selling the toys? Because
they are.
So when they did the train, the Mickey Minis, so I went in there and I was able to buy them all. I think they were selling for like $2 each or something. Yep. Yep. But I think, are they only selling them at the price of the Happy Meal now?
No. They are. Well,
okay.
I mean, I don't know. Maybe every McDonald's is different, but my McDonald's was not. However, they're not too friendly about it. They know what the deal is. If you go on eBay right now, the lot of all 50 are going for $500. Like, that's the low price. You could have bought it about a week or two ago before they came out. And that you could have got for like, I think it was $220, $219 was the lowest I saw.
I remember when you bought all the ones for the train and you got a really good price on those ones.
Yep.
And I went and I paid $2 or $250 each or something. And then I went a few times and they were just giving them to me for free. But I was like, 50 of them. I just don't even think that's the can of worms I want to open.
No.
Like,
the best thing I could say is if you're going to go with the whole family, we have a family of four, and we ordered 4 Happy Meals for lunch on Saturday. I just said, can you just please get me all different toys?
Yeah.
And they said, okay. And that's the way to do it.
Yeah.
But
you know what a good thing about a Happy Meal is? This is just kind of just general tip for everybody. If you're on Weight Watchers, a Happy Meal cheeseburger, the whole kit, it's only like 3 points. So it doesn't dip into your whole day.
What?
You can still have fast food, just get the kids meal. And it doesn't really, it's only a couple points.
You can even have the fries with it?
I don't eat the fries. They're gross, McDonald's.
Oh, I disagree.
I don't eat any fries.
I'm like, what?
I've only had breakfast. I've not had like a Big Mac or fries in probably 15 years.
Wow. Yeah, I like the fries, the coffee, the breakfast, and the ice cream.
Breakfast is like my go-to there.
All right, let's get the show back on track. Enough McDonald's.
Sorry, Dan.
Right? Our new sponsor.
All right. This episode, we are doing a part two only, and it's, 3 years in the making, this part two? Way back when we first started, Holly wasn't even a thought in the Grand Circle Tour podcast's eye. Episode 34. Stan, Caroline, and myself did an episode on our favorite music from Disney attractions. And Jay did a phenomenal job editing. I thought, Jay, that was one of your best works. We talked about it on one of the end of the year or 100th episode or one of those. And we talked about our favorite shows. And I always bring that show up as one of my favorites. So I've been waiting to get Jay on here and Holly because I think you guys could bring a different perspective. And you probably have some crazy facts that none of us know. So.
Oh, yeah, totally. Yeah, you know me and my facts.
I'm texting Justin as we speak.
Yeah.
With a list of all information I need. I know he's on vacation, but.
Justin's in Hawaii.
He's on the lazy river right now, I'm sure.
But I've asked my fellow co-hosts to come up with at least five. We'll do our top five like we normally do. And then Jay, what he's going to do for us is he's going to splice in the music afterwards and make it sound all nice and pretty. So when you're listening to this right now, you'll be able to hear a little snippet of all the music that we talk about.
Hooray!
So nice. With that being said, there was I was trying to give you guys a hint to listen to episode 34 to get a hint about what this episode was going to be about. But I'm pretty sure neither of you did. So I'm going to tell you what happened in episode 34. We started, that was one of the first episodes of Dan's point game. That was the first time we said, you're going to get points. Dan's going to rate you. And we'll see how many points you guys get, depending on how great your answers are. Okay, Holly, you ready for that?
Yeah, I'm ready. It's so funny because I always have a great time recording with you, but I'm always a nervous wreck. Like, what kind of game? What's he going to throw out? Like,
episode 34 was the start of it all. You could have just listened to it. And also,
dude, that was like 300 episodes ago.
Well, what is this? Episode 189?
Maybe next time, give me the topic.
Yeah, we've got
before,
like as many detours and movie reviews and merges. Right? We've got passengers. If you're just tuning in, we've got a lot of content for you.
And if you're one of the passengers that have been with us since episode 34, first of all, thank you for sticking with us. Second of all, I'm gonna repeat some of them because my feelings have not really changed. So I'll go with some of the ones that I don't think my two co-hosts are gonna talk about because I thought we talked a lot of good ones on that episode, but I'm confident we'll get even better ones this time. So with that being said, who wants to start?
Ladies first.
All right.
Okay. Holly, so my go number ahead five. Give us your right?
Yep. Go ahead.
Okay. So my number five. I do not like the movie, but I love the soundtrack and the music that comes from this, from the Haunted Mansion overlay at Disneyland. I know that a lot of people, I think you either love or hate the overlay. Like, there's no in between. And I think, like Justin says, he specifically makes sure his trips are not during that. But I just love the music during this.
So you're talking which one? The holiday? Is that what you're talking
the
about?
The holiday, yes. The Nightmare Before Christmas, the holiday overlay, the music. And I'm kind of thinking that maybe Jay is, this is on his list too, but could be wrong.
You know, I think, the overlay is great, and Jay's going to have a hard time finding that, I think.
Because I don't already own like every version of it, just like, on a hard drive.
But I think the Haunted Mansion is, I mean, just in general, I think that should be crossed off of all our lists right away. I think you get points for all Haunted Mansion soundtracks, because that's, you know, one of the more iconic attraction theme songs out there. So
right.
Jay, anything to add about Haunted Mansion? I'm pretty confident it was on your list of something.
It is on my list. Originally, I scratched off Phantom Manor because I was going to cheat and let an entire attraction be my number one. But for my number five, I did pick the foyer.
We're not done talking about the Haunted Mansion, and we have to give out points and stuff, Jay.
I know, I'm not done. That's the same. Okay. Doing Haunted, number five is Haunted Mansion.
So you're haunted. Hey,
Jumpy McGun, slow down.
So you have the same number five. That's what you're telling me.
I have the same number five, but it's not the same. Not that part.
Okay. Oh, okay. Got it. Okay.
Right.
Go ahead.
So I'll do Holly's first here. And so for my number five, I picked the foyer music from the Haunted Mansion. Both parks, when you come into the mansion for the first time, it's that organy music you hear before the ghost host begins to speak. And there's something about that organ that just sets the stage for the whole attraction. And that one piece of music has always been my favorite from the mansion.
See, I'm definitely out of my league on this. I'm like, I love the whole, all the music. I don't have an exact song, and here we are. The third second of the song from the foyer, when you're 2 feet in,
that's totally me. I'm King Pedantic when it comes to like the music.
The creepy organ, right? That's what you're talking about, right?
Like, yeah. Wait, I have it right here if you want to hear it.
Okay, do you guys know who
Exotencio, yes. Yep.
Do you know who that is, Holly?
No, I don't even know what you're trying to say.
Xavier. X, known in the Disney community. Xavier Atencio. No. So we're going to talk a lot about him, I think, in this episode.
Okay.
He is a writer of a bunch of attraction theme music. And he has a couple. I think two are like the most popular, which we'll probably talk about the other one soon. And if not, I'll bring it up later. And he was the one who wrote Gringotts and Ghosts, right, Jay? Am I right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And a whole bunch of other stuff. So we owe X a lot for making these awesome soundtracks and music.
Cool.
Do you know what Grin and Ghosts, you know what the title came from, where it came from?
I do.
You of do, course Grin? He does.
I do because I minored in Shakespeare at college.
Oh, really?
I did. Because nothing says I want a career. Nothing says I want a career like putting Shakespeare on your school resume.
Wow.
So what's the answer, Jay?
It's from the poem Venus and Adonis. And I could tell you it, but I can't. Now that I'm in front of you guys, I can't recall the exact line.
I went back and listened to episode 34 over the weekend just for prep for the show. And I said in the show that after the show, I would actually go and read it. And I got to be honest, that never happened. So. So after the show, I will go ahead and read it.
It's too funny.
Awesome. All right. Anything else to add about your number five, Jay?
I've pulled up a poem and I'm speed reading, trying to find the passage. I forgot how long this poem was.
Just type in the search.
All right. Let's skip the poem and let's get right to the points, because that's what our passengers want to know. How many points did everyone get? I think you guys kind of tied on that, right? It's kind of the same thing. So we'll start off with 100 points each. How about that?
Do I get a bonus point for being able to Shakespeare it? Don't make that college tuition for nothing.
I got to be honest, Jay. You get negative five for knowing.
I was going to say, I think that brings it down.
So Holly is currently winning with 100 points, and Jay has 95.
Oh, my goodness.
All right. I guess that goes to me for my fifth favorite, which I didn't even put in order. Oh, my God. I'm sorry, guys. I'm such a bad host. But I'll say my fifth favorite is the Soaring soundtrack.
Yeah.
Also part of our nice show opening, right?
Mm-hmm.
For now, I'm going to actually chat with Stan about making a new one.
Oh. Don't get rid of the Soaring one, though, because
okay,
that's like the best music. Soren is my son Connor's favorite attraction.
Aww.
And he always tells me that it's not only the attraction itself, but it's also the music. So that's why I threw this one on here.
He's such a smart kid.
He is a smart kid.
Like, he really is. Yeah.
I mean, Justin's his favorite co-host. He's a really smart kid.
Speaking of Disney, we're going off topic here, but today, plug to my mom and dad, today is their 50th wedding anniversary, Sunday, September 19th, right? So we're sitting at soccer practice, and I see Connor counting on his fingers, and I'm like, what are you doing? And he's like, Dad, did you know that Nana and Pop-Pop got married like 2 weeks before Disney World opened? And I'm like, you're right.
That's so cute. And yeah, happy anniversary to your parents.
Happy anniversary.
Amazing.
All right. Anyway, original score. Who did it, Jay? Do you know?
Why did I just blank?
Jerry Goldsmith.
Thank you.
Jerry Goldsmith, and he went on the attraction before he did wrote the score, and he came out with tears in his eyes. This is how the story goes, and he's like, I'm going to write this for free. So that's the story. When they did the new score for the new Soarin', where was that recorded? Does anyone know where that was recorded? A little trivia here. It's recorded by the London Studio Orchestra in the famous
Abbey Road Studios.
Abbey Road Studios. Very good, Jay. Awesome.
Do I get my 5 points back?
You get your five points so. Back.
Thank you, Professor Snape.
All right. I'll let you guys give me the points. What do you think?
I'm too lazy. It's Sunday.
101? I heard 101. Great. 101 points for me.
Yeah, you definitely get full points for that.
101.
More oh, so what's a one for?
I don't know. That's what I heard. That's what I heard you guys say.
Monroe, did you just say 101?
All right, Holly, what do you have?
Okay, so for my number four, because it's newer, a little bit original, I'm going to go with Mickey and Minnie's Runaway, No One Can Stop Us Now.
Nothing can stop us now. I'll tell you how we're going to make it happen. Let's take a ride and spend the day in the countryside.
Good times are here to stay. Woo! We'll get away and have the perfect picnic. We'll sing a song.
It's a fun song. It's something new, different. So, and it kind of gets in your head.
I love that you picked this. I got to be honest. I love that you picked this. When our last trip in July, this was the song that everyone was singing the whole trip.
So funny. Right? Like, just like gets in your head. It's kind of like it's a small world, how it just like sticks in your head. And then I don't know. It's just fun. I like
I was watching the Mickey Mouse shorts this weekend, catching up on them finally. And it is catchy because every time the credits play, I would hear in my head, no, thank you. No.
And you sing it with that like weird like tone. I don't know. Yeah.
Well, what's so great about that song? That's the first original song we've had for an attraction.
Yeah.
In decades.
Mm-hmm.
You know what else is cool about that song? That was what's her name? Who's the one that voiced Minnie Mouse?
Rusty Taylor.
Rusty Taylor. That was her last thing she ever did before she passed away. Aww. As Minnie Mouse. And they actually dedicated that song to her. Nothing can stop us now.
Love that.
Dedicated to
love
her.
That. That's so cool.
Yeah. Very cool.
It's also a great theme song when you're driving down to the park. You know, nothing can stop us now. No traffic.
Except traffic. No, actually, and great. COVID and all that.
The line is Starbucks.
Yeah. Good job, Holly. I'm going to give you another 100 points for that one. I love that, the originality of that one. I like that.
Thanks.
Jason.
I am going to go.
By the way, I'm sorry. Before you go, Jay, Holly, did I just see a pen? Are you writing this stuff down?
Yeah, I was writing the points down.
Okay. Just to let you know, if you're new to the show, Holly, the points don't really matter. Okay. Just letting you know.
I am such a doodler. Like, I just. Like doodle. So I don't even know whose these are. I just keep writing 100, 101, 95. Like I just write this stuff down.
All right. At the end, Dan is going to win. Just, fast forward a little bit.
Maybe not. Maybe not.
To plug the solo show that I was just on. What I said when we did our music episode last week was, I don't care if I win or lose. I'm just here to have a good time with friends.
Oh, okay. That's what it is. Yes. Let's
see. I'm just here to have a good time with friends. Now, I won that game.
Cool.
But, I know Dan's
scoring system. You're not winning today.
I'm third today. I know it. So.
All right, Jay. What's your number four?
And I have it prepared for you guys. My number four is a real song. It is used in the cue of Tower of Terror. It's by jazz legend Sidney Bechet. And the track is called When the Sun Sets Down South. And there's something about this track, and it doesn't matter which tower I've been to, it just feels like it was made for this ride. I'll give you a quick preview.
I know, I'm like, I can't picture this or like.
I would never have thought that was written just for the Tower of Terror.
It wasn't. It's a real song.
Oh, it's a real song.
Yeah, it's a real song. Yeah. It was released in the 30s, and you would think it was made just for this ride. And when
I love that.
This is the original recording version. When you hear it through all that spooky reverb and echo, it just really puts you in that time of in place of spooky, haunted Hollywood. And I have a playlist on my phone titled Hollywood 1939. That is every song from the cue playlist.
Oh.
That's cool. Wow.
I love this song. I've always loved this song, and it is just Tower to me.
Wow. Yeah.
Think of just who would have thought that Tower of Terror song would be on Jay's list, right? I mean,
I know. Shocking, right?
So weird. Yeah. So weird.
It's like I've bent over backwards to include the tower.
Jay, awesome job. You need a lot of points for that. 26 points for you for that one.
Woohoo!
26?
I was waiting for you to say that.
Yeah, I don't care if I win or lose. I'm having a good time.
I thought thought that was definitely.
I won on the solo show. That makes me a winner.
You get extra points.
Makes you something.
All right. Even though this is my number four on our list, it's probably my number one overall. I just don't want one of you guys to steal it, so I'm going to say it now. And let's see what I can say before I reveal it. It's the second song that was in this attraction. It's an attraction that switched over from Disneyland to Disney World, and it had a different song entitled Best Time of Our Life in Disneyland. But when it
reverse it. Yeah. Well, that was when it went to Disney World. Sorry.
When it went to Disney World, it was called?
When it went to Disney World, it became Best Time of Your Life because GE wanted people to think now and not tomorrow.
Got right, which was
when they go to buy appliances.
Yep. The song we're talking about, because now you guys are all wondering what the hell are they talking about, is Great Big Beautiful Tomorrow. And
good one.
What Jay just said right there is it's funny because one song is talking about the present.
Now is the time. Now is the best time. Now is the best time of your life. Life is a prize. Live every minute. Open your eyes and watch how you win it. Yesterday's memories may sparkle and gleam. Tomorrow is still but a dream. Right here and now, you've got it made. The world's forward marching and you're in the parade. Now is the time, now is the best time. It's the time of joy or strife. There's so much to cheer for. Be glad you're here, for it's the best time of your life.
And one song is talking about the future. Mm-hmm. It makes you think. What's more important? Is it more important to talk about the present, or is it more important to talk about the future? So, my personal opinion, it's more important to talk about the future. Thus, one of the biggest earworms, I would say, out there, maybe even more than like Small World, is this song. Written by who, Jay?
The Sherman Brothers.
Sherman Brothers, exactly. And I saw a quote from one of the Sherman Brothers that they said that when they wrote it, they had Walt specifically in mind. So very cool when you're listening to that song that you know that it was written specifically for Walt.
And he loved it. And the version you're going to hear, Passengers, isn't the normal version. The track you're about to hear is called Mirror Maze. It's a version of Great Big Beautiful Tomorrow written by the Sherman Brothers back in the 60s when the show was at the 64 World's Fair. You would exit through a ramp up to the second floor. One of the first things you would do was go through a mirror maze. And so this track you're about to hear is just a really cool, funky variation of that song.
Awesome, Jay. Love Jay, because it was my choice, I'm going to get most of the points, but I am going to give you some for the assist there. So I'll give myself 90 points, and I'll give you 3, okay?
Woohoo!
Thank you for that.
1,003, right? Because no, I went three. Really obscure for yours.
Just 3.
I'm trying to grease the wheels here.
Holly, you're number 3.
Now I really wish I would have done some more digging because I feel so generic now. But Splash Mountain has some great music. I love that there's a storyline with the music. So you go through, you know, like the laugh in place, and then you go through like the antagonist part, and you end with happiness. So I love how it's not just one song throughout the whole ride, because it's a pretty long ride, and they actually tell a story with just the songs in it, and it goes along perfectly, and it builds you up for that drop. And it's funny because I've been on that ride numerous times, but I still get that like tension and nervousness just because of the music. I'm not scared of the drop, but you have this music and the oh my goodness, those birds, what the heck,
vultures.
The crows, the vultures. And so it just brings this like antagonist scary feeling, and then the second you're done, you're in Doodah Landing and all is well, you know. So once again, like I said, I picked these songs for how like the rides make me feel and the energy that they give me. So although it's kind of generic, and this is, you know,
the specific track you're talking about is called
Burrows.
No, it's not Burrows Lament. It's a scary version of Laughing Place.
Mm-hmm.
And the way it really goes from a fun song to a creepy, oh my God, you're about to die.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let me out of here!
What can a red rabbit do to keep from becoming rabbit stew? Warning, red rabbit is wasting my breath. The rabbit is facing certain death. Don't you go to the laughing place, or the fox will get you too.
And then especially when...
And the way it just pitches up. Sorry.
Yeah. It's...
So, like Holly, this is not generic. This is one of the greatest songs of all time. If you listen to episode 34, you would have heard that I use this. And I'm going to be fair, because there's three different songs in here. You're going to get three sets of points, because that's what happened when I used it. And it really is. I mean, it's my favorite attraction, right? Everyone knows that, and I love the drop. I love the fact that it's 9.5 minutes long. But I love the music. That's like the most important part about it. And it's, you know, for me personally, music is like my favorite sense, if that makes any sense.
No, totally.
Sound is what always gets me, right?
Mm-hmm.
Sound to me, I could be in the crappiest mood in the world and I could put on a song and it could change me like that, right? Or vice versa. I could be in a happy mood and I could listen to something that brings up a bad memory and I could just lose it, right?
Right, yeah.
And for this attraction, I think it helps you bring through those range of emotions, you know.
And if I wasn't so not worried about, because at Disneyland you get soaked, which sometimes it's a hassle, right? I cannot stand soggy shoes. If it weren't for that, this would be up there in my like top three, because I really do love this attraction and I go on it every single time. But I'm always like, okay, how drenched am I going to get? Am I going to be uncomfortable? You know, it's because of the music. It really is.
Can I get a human-sized Ziploc bag to put myself in? Open them out.
I mean, I put a poncho and a pair of flip-flops in my bag, and that's what I change it to right before.
Yeah, and I'm not worried about, like, my hair or any of that. I'm just worried about the soggy butt and the soggy shoes. That's just so uncomfortable. So, but yeah, it's just so great. And it, once again, it's the music that really brings that attraction together.
There's the episode title, Soggy Butt, Soggy Shoes.
So a couple of facts I had, because you definitely stole this one from me. Let's start with how do you do, right? That's the first one. How do you do, right?
Sure to come down. A penny lost is a penny found.
must. We'll do what we like, cause that suits us. How do you do? Mighty pleasant greeting. Pretty good sure as you're born. Pretty good sure as you're born. How do you do?
Jay will do that. Jay will put it in right now.
You say it and I'll just, there's going to be music under this whole thing.
Recorded especially for the ride in 1988 by the Flozzies, spelled F-L-O-O-Z-I-E-S, which was a 29-piece band from Oregon. This is my little tidbit.
The Flozzies, sorry to correct you.
Flozzies?
The Flozzies.
Okay, sorry, Flozzies.
I told you I'm Disney pedantic music guy, sorry. You knew it was going to happen by having me on. I was going to be like, no, Dan, actually...
All right, then who sung Everyone's Got a Laughing Place for the original Disneyland soundtrack, Jay?
Oh, I can't remember right now.
That is sung by Elisa, Georgia, and Castell Newton, three sisters from California who worked for the Walt Disney Company at the time of the ride's construction and were asked to help out with the vocals.
I don't know everything yet. I had yesterday off.
And here's my favorite little thing about this ride is Zippity-Doo-Dah was recorded by a choir consisting of over 75 cast members to record the last score, which I think is pretty awesome.
Yeah, love that.
Do you guys want to hear the Madonna Splash Mountain connection?
Sure.
Let me go crazy in the weeds for you here. There is a track in the queue called Sooner or Later, which is an instrumental version of a song from Song of the South that was sung by Hattie McDaniel. If you guys don't know who that is, that was Mammy and Gone with the Wind. And when they did the soundtrack to Dick Tracy, Madonna did a cover of that song and released it on the soundtrack.
Interesting.
Wow, look at that. It's full of
useless information. Disney information.
No wonder why Stan always gets you and Justin confused.
All right, Holly. 300 points for each song. You just scored 300 points total.
Sweet. Let me write that down.
Make sure my math is correct at the end. All right, Jay.
All right. I am going to skip over to Epcot this time. And for my number three, it's going to be Tomorrow's Child from Spaceship Earth, the original version of Tomorrow's Child. Love that song. Love everything it says about the ride, about the future. But the best part is, and they don't do this anymore, and I wish they'd bring this back, but the back half of that song is a really beautiful, inspirational, tomorrow-ish instrumental. And that's what you used to hear when you get to space and then turn and go back down. And I'm going to put that piece of music right here. Cool. I can do it for real.
Very cool. I wish I had a fun fact about that song, but I don't.
I don't either. I really, believe it or not, there's no fun facts with that song. It was everything original Epcot was supposed to be, and it's just a real shame it's not there anymore.
Yeah, definitely. All right, let's move on to my next one. Let's talk about my next one. Let's go with this one. I believe this was the first attraction with audio animatronics. I know it was the first attraction with air conditioning because we put that on our Instagram page the other day, Holly. It was originally intended to be a dinner show, which the middle fountain part was supposed to be a coffee bar.
Well, now I have to cross number two off my list.
And if you don't know which song I'm talking about right now, it is Jay, you want to sing it for us?
Do you really, really want me to?
I'll sing it. Yeah. The tiki room. Tiki Room, one of my favorite songs out there. It's funny. I took a family with us to Disney, and they've been a couple times, and I took them into the Tiki Room, and they were like, what is this? And the kids kind of looked around like, are we like on drugs right now? Like, what's going on right now? And the parents absolutely loved it. And when we did the wrap-up show, actually, we did a show for this podcast, and Fred was on there, and Fred was like, man, I just always walked right past that. I never even knew that was like a cool attraction in there.
Forgot this one on my list. Like I probably sing that every day of my life. Like I honestly can't believe I forgot this. And the things I picked now, I'm like, no, not really. But like, really, yeah, so yeah. Good.
Okay. Holly, who wrote the Tiki Room lyrics?
I don't know.
I'll take a guess.
I don't know.
I'll give you a hint. There's two of them. They're brothers.
The Sherman Brothers.
Very good.
I was gonna guess that, but
I was hoping she'd say the Jonas Brothers.
That would have been good.
Can you put a Jonas Brothers song on right now, Jay? Right here?
No, I do not own the Jonas Brothers, and I will not defile our wonderful.
That would have been so funny.
I will not bring trash music into this house.
I saw you.
Oh, Dan, can you sing a little more? I promise I'm not going to capture it.
I can't get the high notes that Nick gets.
Just doesn't matter. Just sing it. I promise I won't save it for later.
I do like the new songs, great. Though. I have to admit. Anyway, Holly, you're up again.
Already? Okay.
Yeah.
Number two is an entire show. And I'm going with Fantasmic.
Oh, very good one.
So that's one of those. Obviously,
wait,
there's.
Wait, hold up. I call foul because she just pulled in every Disney song ever.
I know, but it's the compilation of all of it together that brings the whole show together. And I was trying to look up like the individual songs, but I couldn't find it because it's just. What is it? The Imagination song? Like they just put all the songs in there. So I was trying to find the snippet, but I just didn't have time, truthfully. So Jay, there.
I got it. Passengers, it's this piece of music right here.
So how many points, like what does she get points for here?
Is it probably negative.
Actually,
yeah.
You need to take 1,000 points away.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't really want to do this, Holly, but Jay told me to. So
I know.
Just make it 200. Don't do that. Don't, you know, I don't care if I win or lose. Let the girl win.
All right.
Let the girl win.
200 points.
I don't want to win because I'm the girl.
You're not going to win, Holly. I'm going to win.
Love it.
So it's really just a competition between me and Holly.
No, you guys can exactly. Five for left.
Yeah.
All right, Jay. Number four.
All right. My number four, since you stole the Tiki Room, I was just going to do a specific piece of music, but I'm going to cross it off my list. I'm going back to Epcot, and I'm going to the one that got away, one of those real loves of my life, Horizons.
Oh.
And going to go with another really pretty piece of instrumental music. This is the space theme from Horizons. And this is when you come out of the sea and you take off into space and you see the shuttles. And it's this really pretty piece of music you're going to hear right here.
Sorry, apparently there's some motorcycle racing going on my street right now.
That is a good one, Jay, because, you know, that is something that I know you talk about a lot on the show, Horizons. And I've seen some videos, but have to be truthful. Like, I really don't remember riding it. I know I did, but, you know, I don't remember all of that. So it's good to hear stuff.
It really is one of the single greatest rides Disney ever created. It was the sequel to Carousel of Progress. Dan, I'm going to send you Martin's video to watch. It's like an hour and a half. So take it in at your leisure.
Yeah.
But Horizons, guys, it is truly a shame it's no longer with us. I would put it in the top 7 or 10 Disney attractions ever made in history.
Wow.
Nothing was so upbeat and hopeful for the future, which is what we need right now.
So you're saying top 10 of all time. So what is it? Alien Swirling Saucers is number one.
Ellen's Energy Adventure. Velocicoaster.
I liked Ellen's Energy Adventure. It was a nice break.
Yeah, nice nap. We should do a show on top 5 naps, like places.
Okay, I just told Stan that today.
That's a good idea.
That was my next time I host was going to be top places to nap in the parks.
All right, Jay, that's a great one. I'm going to give you 200 points for that one as well. That was really good.
I'll take anything in Horizons.
Remind me, I need to watch the YouTube of Horizons.
I'll send you like the documentary on her. There's two, and I'll send them both to you.
Okay.
One is Hoot and Chief. I would never show that to the passengers because its behavior should never exhibit at Disney parks. They're giant machines. Don't get out of the cars, whatever.
Oh, I have actually seen that one. I have seen that. Yep.
Yeah. That one teaches you how to get your friend's ashes into Disney.
Right.
Oh, goodness.
Yeah. All right. I'm up, I think, right? My number four.
Two.
Number two. I'm sorry. Fourth one. But number two,
yes.
Going backwards. All right, Holly. This is to one up you a little bit.
There's no competition, but you're trying to make like you're already kicking my butt. But.
Well, I jumped in. He was watching sports. He wants this to be sports. Dan, we're not the Mets. Don't try to make us fight.
I'm only saying that because I gave you three sets of points because you gave me an attraction with a full song with lyrics, okay. Right?
Got it.
The Fantasmic one was a little bit of an you know. But yeah. I'm going to give you an attraction that has 13 songs in it, full songs, all with lyrics. Can you think of what attraction I'm talking about? I'm going to sing you my favorite of the songs right now. Ready? There was
blood
on the saddle.
I'm surprised Jay didn't have this one.
Dan, I need you to sing that again, but sing the additional bar.
Blood all around. That part. Blood on the saddle is just one of the 13. Also, Bear Band Serenade. If you can't bite, don't growl. She ain't pretty, but she don't swear none. One of my favorites. Mama, don't whoop little Buford.
Okay, wait, hold that, guys. Really quick, that is a real song. Passengers, if you've never heard it, go to YouTube right now because it's about a family trying to ditch one of their own. And it's like everything they can do to get rid of him. Go find Mama, don't little whoop Buford right now. Take a pause, listen, and come back.
Mama, don't whoop little Buford. Mama, don't pound on his head. Mama, don't whoop little Buford. I think you should shoot him instead. Buford brought home his report card. Buford was proud as could be. At last he had passed to the third grade, and Buford is just 23.
Those are only like the starters of this of the titles of the songs. This one's great. The tears will be the chaser for your wine. How long will my baby be gone? My personal favorite one. They're all my personal favorite. All the guys that turn me on, turn me down.
Every time I meet a guy who gets me shook, all I ever get from him's a dirty look. It's the same way everywhere I found. All the guys that turn me on, turn me down. All the guys that turn me on, turn me down. Nothing works for me that I found. It's the same way everywhere I see. Nothing ever seems to work for me.
Blood on the Saddle, Ballad of Davy Crockett, and Come Again, and a couple other ones. So, listen. Country Bear Jamboree is my favorite attraction to bring a brand new Disney fan to. Because the looks on their faces, sometimes they might be sitting there on their phones or kind of like looking at the moose heads moving around or whatever. And then they'll hear a lyric and they'll face like their head go back a second, right? You guys know what I'm talking about. And they'll be like, did they just say that? Aren't we at Disney World? And then the next song will come on, and they're like, and then their neck snaps over to me, and they're like, what is going on in this attraction? And I love that. That's my sense of humor right there. So.
That was me this past January because I haven't watched that show in, I have no idea. And I forgot those songs, and the same thing, I'm like, what? Because when you're young, a child, I can't tell you how old I was. You don't really listen to the lyrics. You just pay attention to the bears and
it's been gone 21 years. So I'm guessing if you were three or four.
Yeah, totally. but so same thing. That was totally Chris and I were like, wait, what? Like, what are they saying? Wow, it's been a long time since I've watched this show.
And it's only a matter of time by the time we get around to version 3 of this episode, in another 5-10 years, I bet you some of those songs will be gone.
I was just going to say, if you enjoy this show, enjoy it during the 50th, because once the 50th is over, the physical show isn't going away, but all the audio is. They're going to reprogram it with all new. So go enjoy this classic while you still can. It's been 20 years. I'm still mad at Disneyland for this.
Yeah. Isn't there a movie, or was there a movie?
There was a terrible, awful, horrible, hideous nightmare fuel. Don't watch this unless you want to have just hideous dreams.
What?
It was the second. The Country Bears. Second movie they made based off a ride. And oof, if you thought Haunted Mansion was bad.
I need to look at it.
No, don't.
It was in that era where they made Haunted Mansion, and then they made the Tower of Terror movie, and then they made this movie, those three.
Yeah, okay. they did Tower, okay. They did Country Bears, they did Pirates, and then Mansion, and... It's kind of like Star Trek, where the odd movies are bad. With Disney, the even movies are bad.
So funny.
So, because it's 13 full songs with lyrics, I'm getting 13 sets of points.
Wow.
And all are worth 1,000 points. So I just put 13,000.
You know, I could edit this and give you 13 points altogether.
Yeah.
All right, Jay, your last one. Your number
one. My last one is by the incredible, the amazing George Bruns, who's given us some of the best Disney music there is. Dan, you haven't been to Disneyland yet, right?
I have.
Okay.
Long time
this
ago.
You will only hear this music at the Disneyland version of the attraction. This is called Scareby music, and this is when you go through the caves before the big battle of pirates. Dan rocking out.
I have that on CD.
This is perfect 60s. This is Disney 60s. This you don't hear these kind of instruments or arrangements anymore. And so this is going to leap to the top of my list here, because it's so set in a moment in time, but it's so timeless. And it's only at Disneyland.
George Bruns did the music, and who did the lyrics for Yo-Ho? You know
Extensio.
That? Extensio, exactly.
I have X's autograph, and it's just an X. Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
That's cool.
Great. So if you don't know who X is, X, and I talked about him earlier in the show, he did both A Pirate's Life for Me and Haunted Mansion, Grin and Ghost. So that's pretty cool to have both of those under your belt, right?
Jay, I love that you picked music like that. That is... like so important, and like the second you play it, like I know where it's from, and it makes the whole ride, right? That whole section. But like I wouldn't think to pick something like that. I would pick Yo Ho Ho. You know what I mean? Like it's so.
When Dan said pick songs, he didn't specify, and so you and me, I'm gonna go deep out in the weeds.
Yeah, no, that's I love it.
I love it too. The only problem is it's not worth enough points, because if you just went Yo Ho Yo Ho, I would have gave you like 5,000, but you're only going to get 1,000.
It's the Yo-Ho. It's the scare me version of Yo-Ho.
All right. Who is that? Did I skip Holly?
You did, but that's okay.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Holly.
So we had, as I told you earlier, we had a birthday party today for the twins. Well, Lincoln got... a new Star Wars set. So every couple seconds during this recording, I keep having to put mute because he keeps coming over to ask. He can pretty much do the whole like instructions by himself. But every once in a while he gets stuck. So he keeps like, because you'll see it says like times three. And he's like, do I have to make three of these? So sorry, that's why I keep pushing me. But, and he keeps saying, can I show them?
Lincoln, that looks awesome.
They said it looks awesome. So sorry. But the second he gets a Lego set, he has to open it and put it together like immediately. So this is the one he just got.
By the way, they just opened the They just opened the Legoland in New York. So we're super stoked.
Oh, cool. Very cool. Okay. So my number one is my absolute favorite show. And let me see. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, so I guess I'm still losing. There's only 9 songs on in this show, but it's only at Disneyland, and they do it every night with the fireworks. And one of the last times I watched this show was a few weeks ago, and I was so irritated because they have the most energetic, fun music, and these people were sitting on the ground. I actually recorded and said, how do you sit on the ground when they're playing this music? So this is Mickey's Mix Magic show, and the music is so great, and they do the projections on the castle and on It's a Small World and down Main Street, and it is so fun. It's like a DJ mix of all the greatest songs all together, and it's so high energy, and I don't understand how people can just sit there.
It's the end of a long day at Disneyland. Those legs don't want us to work anymore.
No, it like revives you. That's like my revival moment. So I'm tired. It's 9 o'clock. We've been there all day. That's my revival moment to go hard the next 2 hours before the park closes. So they do all these, oh my goodness, sorry, he just hit himself. Like, so they do a special song that it's a good time, I want to be like you. And so they have all these characters on the projections as well. And it's just so fun. Like, I absolutely love, love, love this show. So I was so excited when they brought it back after COVID, because I'm like, okay, I'm going. I got to go see this show.
I love how, just like you said, you love how Jay like picked these obscure things. I love how you give these things from Disneyland that I honestly have no clue about. But now I'm like, wow, that sounds awesome. Like, I really want to hear that.
Especially because of the projections, because they bring part of the animation from the original movies. And so they do part of like the song from Dumbo, and they bring the pink elephants out and like little things like that. And it's so fun because it ties it back into the original movies as well, and the great music. And like I said, that just gives me such energy. And they have the fireworks, which honestly, I don't even think they need the fireworks at this point, because it kind of takes away, because they're loud, and kind of takes away from the projections. Like, the projections are amazing. And so, and
you've seen the projections on Cinderella Castle. Imagine that on the small facade. Mm-hmm. It is really cool looking.
Yeah, and so they do it down Main Street on the castle, and you can get an even better spot in It's a Small World, because most people don't think to go over there because they don't know that they're going to do the projections over there. So that's a really nice area to watch. Well,
now they do. Thanks, Holly.
Very cool. So how many songs are on that?
Nine. I think at least 9. Yeah.
All right. I'm gonna pause for a second and think about it. Okay. So I'm not gonna give you my answer yet. We're gonna do it.
And I have a chance to earn some points back. I have found the line from Shakespeare.
Oh.
I'm sure that's just what our listeners want to hear right now, Jack.
Yeah, you're probably right. You're probably an hour in. I'm not gonna do Shakespeare.
All right. My last one, and this will be the last one, and we only have a few minutes left here. So, you know, I hate you guys. I really do. I do. Because you're putting me in a bad spot. You really are. You're putting me in a spot where I'm forced to say this because we just have to include it. But if I'm being honest with myself, I have to give myself negative points for it because I can't stand it. But how do we go a show talking about attraction music without talking about It's a Small World, right?
We have to bring it up. We were trying not to.
You both lose all points if you hate Small World.
I don't hate Small World. Yeah. I'm just saying that it's not one of my most favorite songs, right? And I think millions of other people would agree with me with that.
They can be wrong, too.
They could be wrong. They could be wrong. But in all honesty, I will give myself negative points for this one. But that being said, 240? Is it 240 animatronics in the attraction? Jay, what was the original name of the song? Do you know?
Oh, my God. It was... I could think of... why did you do this to me? It's like Jeopardy. It's on the tip of my tongue.
I like doing it.
I could see the words, but I can't get them out.
It was called Children of the World.
Of the World. Thank you.
Children of the World. Written by who? Colin?
The Sherman.
Sorry. It's okay. That one. But, I mean, honestly, you're right. You're right, Dan. Like, it really is awesome that you can put this song into so many different languages. And so many different animatronics. And so I agree. We do have to talk about that. But
and I think It's a Small World. You know, we talked about, like, you know, our senses and stuff. You know, you listen to the music and then you also use your sense of sight by looking at the Mary Blair artwork. Mm-hmm. And it brings it all together. Right. Yeah. And it's created something that is basically iconic, you know.
It is.
It is. Sherman Brothers wrote this song in the wake of the 1962 Cuban Missile Crisis. Did you guys know that? Mm-hmm. And basically, it's a song. The message was peace and brotherhood. And they took that song and made it to what it is today. So we can make fun of it all we want, but it is probably one of the more recognizable songs when you think of Disney. Go ahead, Jay.
Can I get 5,000 points if I give you the most obscure story? And it involves Small World. We have some obscure story about the creation of Small World, I mean.
You can try.
Sure, go. Quick, a few minutes.
There would be no It's a Small World if it wasn't for Joan Crawford. When Pepsi approached Disney for the 64 World's Fair, he came to them and said, this is what we're going to do. And because they were friends and Pepsi said no, she stood up and in Hollywood fashion said, gentlemen, we are doing this. And that is the history of Small World.
Really?
There you awesome. Go.
Bonus cool. points for you. Bonus points. All right, so let's real quick. We got to add Jay's bonus points there. We have Holly's mystery points that I'm about to add. I have to do my negative points. Let me just write this down. Let me write this down. Carry the one.
Oh, he's using an abacus.
And here we go. Okay, coming in fourth place. Fourth place? What? All right, fourth place is Jay. 1,262 points. Good job, Jay. Coming in third place is George. What? He's not even on the show anymore.
Who? I don't know who that is.
All right, George disqualified. Jay, you just moved up to third place. Good job.
Woohoo!
And of course, it's between Holly and I. And coming in first place is, of course, oh my goodness, Holly, you won this one. How did you beat me?
What?
Holy, you beat me by a half a point. Half a point. Holy moly. It's the first time I ever lost.
Oh, that's amazing.
Great job, Holly. Great job. Jay, Holly, awesome time as always with my two favorite co-hosts talking about one of my favorite topics, and I think one of your favorite topics. Jay, would you have?
I could do this all day. One last thing, guys. I did a special, one of my honorable mentions for tonight's episode that didn't come up. It is the disco music from Horizons. The outro to this episode is longer than it would normally be. It's a full 2 minutes because I want you to hear that delicious 70s disco. Enjoy it.
I have 5 pages of extra songs that I want honorable mentions, let's say. But we're approaching an hour, and we're going to add time with the music. So I know this is pretty going long. So we will save that for the comments on our Facebook and Instagram pages. Holly, any last words?
Nope. I'm good. This is a lot of fun.
Thank you guys so much. And Ken, take it away.
If you would like to keep the adventure going after the show, be sure to like our Facebook friends page, Grand Circle Tours Magical Ticket Holders. While you're on Facebook, like our group page, Grand Circle Tours. Be sure to follow us on Twitter, Grand Circle Tours Podcast, as well as on Instagram, GCT Podcast, and our YouTube channel, Grand Circle Tour. If you would like to email us, drop us a line at gctpodcast@gmail.com. T-shirts and other fun merchandise can be found at tpublic.com. Simply search Grand Circle Tour Podcast. If you enjoyed your adventure, leave us a review on Apple Podcast. Only one rule, make it good. All logos, sounds, songs, and music that are made by and for Disney and its affiliates are the full ownership of the Disney Corporation and are not, nor are they intended to be, the ownership of the Grand Circle Tour Podcast. Thank you for riding with us, and welcome home.
Please exit to your left by stepping away from the cars with your left foot first. Step out and stand on the moving platform, please.
Please exit by stepping away from the cars with your left foot first. Step out and stand on the moving platform, please.